चले दरूद शरीफ पढ़ें सब लोग।
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى حميد مجيد.
السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. الحمد للہ الذی نحمدہ ونصلی علی رسولہ الکریم، اما بعد فاعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. ایوریبڈی سے دا دعاز لاؤڈلی، ربی اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی، رب زدنا علما، اللہم فقہنا فی الدین، اللہم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما. ٹوڈے ویل بی اسٹارٹنگ سورۃ البقرہ فرام آیا نمبر، سورۃ البقرہ آیا نمبر 55 آن ورڈ. لیٹس فرسٹ لسن ٹو دا ریسیٹیشن آف فیو آیا فرام 55. اوکے، آیا نمبر 55 وی آر اسٹارٹنگ. So these were the ayah 55, 56 and 57. So everybody has got ayah 55? You have 55? You are looking at the 55? Okay. Hiba, you also? Right, okay. So, وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَىٰ لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّىٰ نَرَى اللَّهُ جَهْرَةً فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ الصَّاعِقَةُ وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. And remember when you said, O Musa, who are you? You are here, Bani Israel. Okay, Allah is addressing whom? Bani Israel. That, O Bani Israel, you said to Musa, your prophet. Musa alayhi salam was their messenger, their prophet. We shall never believe in you until we see Allah plainly. But you were seized with a thunderbolt lightning while you were looking. This is ayah number 55. And recall when you said, O Musa, we will never believe you until we see Allah outright. Openly, they want to see Allah openly. Jaharatan. What is the, you see the ayah? That way, Iskultum Musa, Lannumina Hatta Narallahu Jaharatan. Jaharatan means openly, publicly. Can you see Allah openly, publicly? No, no one can see. Allah is in ghaib, okay? Only on the day of, after this life, we would be able to see Allah. Those who go to Jannah, they will only be able to see, okay? So, we will never believe you until we see Allah outright. Outright means openly or publicly. So the thunderbolt, saika. Saika means thunderbolt. The ayah says saika. So the thunderbolt took you while you were looking on. And they saw the thunderbolt with their own eyes. Here they say that we won't believe. Here believing means that we won't believe in Torah. They were given the book Torah, right? So we won't believe in you, we won't believe in Torah until and unless we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jahara. Publicly, openly. So, you know, when we pray salah, five times prayers, okay? So, there are two types of prayers, jahari and sirri. So here is the word jahara, no? So, you should know what is jahara and what. Jahara is, you know, open publicly. Okay. So there are two types of prayers, Sirri and Jahari. Sirri is Zohar and Asar. Which prayers are Sirri? Zohar and Asar. In that, you know, Imam do not recite the Qiraat, Quran loudly. Whenever you go to mosque, supposing you are praying Zohar with the Imam. In Zohar and in Asar prayers, Imam won't recite the Quran, the Qira, loudly. He will be reciting in his heart. And those who are following him, they will also recite in heart. So two, Sir means hiding, you know, not telling loudly, not loudly. So there are two prayers which are Sirri, Zohar and Asar means what? That the Imam doesn't do the Qira loudly. Got the point? Okay. And the three more prayers, that is Fajr and Maghrib and Isha, the Imam, you know, recite the Qiraat loudly. These three prayers are Jahari. Which are Jahari? Fajr, yes. Fajr, Maghrib and Isha. And they are Jahari in which the Imam do the Qiraat loudly. It can be heard. We can hear the Imam. Okay. So what you got from Jahari? What is Jahari? Yes. 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 Loudly. Yes. You can hear through the Imam. He recites loudly, Jahari, openly. Okay. And in Fajr, in Zohar and Asar, Imam doesn't recite the Quran, the Qira, loudly. Okay. So Jahari means, Jaharatan means openly, loudly. That, oh Musa, we won't believe in you until and unless we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala openly or publicly. So number 56. Then we raised up you up after your death so that you might be grateful. So then what happened? Allah says that what Allah did, so the thunderbolt took you while you were looking on. When they said this, that we won't believe in you until and unless we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, outright, openly, publicly. So what punishment they got? So the thunderbolt took you while you were looking on. You know? So the number of ayah 56 says, then we revived you after your death, that perhaps you would be grateful. When Musa alayhi salam returned with the scripture, Allah called Musa alayhi salam. In the previous ayah, what you read? Allah called Musa alayhi salam to the Mount Tur. Okay, Mount Tur, and he went to the Mount Tur to get what? To get Torah, to get the scripture. Okay, so the Bani Israel said, when we want to hear Allah too, you know, he came with Torah at the time when Musa alayhi salam came with Torah. Bani Israel said, instead of, you know, reciting Torah, learning from that, passing their lives according to the rules of the Torah, they said, no, we want to hear Allah too. We want to see Allah publicly. So Musa alayhi salam took along with him 70 people. So what Musa alayhi salam did? Musa alayhi salam fulfilled their demand. He took 70 people among them, not the whole nation. How many people he took? 70. He took 70 people with him to the mount. And when they got there, they said, we need to see Allah. And at their demand to see Allah, lightning fell on them. They said, we also want to hear Allah on the mount too. We will hear Allah. And when they reached there, they said, no. Their demand was that now we want to see Allah. First, they wanted to hear. When Musa alayhi salam took to the mount, after reaching at the mount, they said, now we want to see Allah. So what happened? To see Allah, lightning fell on them and they all died. With the thunderbolt, with the lightning, they all died. Musa alayhi salam prayed and Allah brought those people back to life. Because Musa alayhi salam prayed and said, oh Allah, due to some foolish people. They were the foolish people. Due to some foolish people, they have died and they are only going to witness there. And if they die, then what will happen? So Musa alayhi salam prayed for them. So Allah brought those people back to life. So what do we see here? What do we see? The deen, the religion of Allah should not be taken lightly. Because they took the religion lightly. They were mocking. Sometimes they want to hear Allah. Sometimes they want to see Allah. So they were taking the religion very lightly. So they got the punishment. The thunderbolt, you know, strike them. They all died. And when Musa alayhi salam prayed for them, then what happened? Allah brought those people back to life. So we shouldn't take the deen lightly, the religion lightly. And one must not demand all the time that the deen be proven to him. Not always say that, prove this, prove that, you know. And one must not demand all the time that the deen be proven to him. That I will not believe Allah until I have seen him or I'll hear him. So we shouldn't do that like Bani Israel. Because the incidence of Bani Israel is example for us. This is an example. The whole Quran is an example. Allah showed us that they did this, they do that, you know, they disobeyed Allah, they transgressed, and their lives were not according to the Quran and Sunnah, which is why they were punished, you know. And when Bani Israel eventually crossed the sea, when they left Egypt, Pharaoh was drowned, they entered into an open desert. You everybody knows, in the last time we read, that what happened? Bani Israel crossed the sea, and Pharaoh was drowned in the water. And you know, they left Egypt. Where they were drawn? Bani Israel? In Egypt. They used to live in Egypt. So now they left, Egypt. They left Egypt and now they entered into an open desert. Okay? No, Ayah 57. And we shaded you with the clouds and sent down on you al-manna and the quails, saying, eat of the good lawful things we have provided for you, but they rebelled. And they did not wrong us, but they wronged themselves. Now, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us about the blessings which He bestowed on Bani Israel. And here it is said that Allah says that we shaded you with clouds because they were in the open desert. Yes.
I have seen a movie about it.
You have seen the movie about it? Yeah.
You know what they have?
Can you say loudly?
They have Yom Kippur.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yes.
Ashura we have.
Yeah.
That they, Jewish people, they believe that they got rid of Pharaoh.
Yeah.
Because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Yeah.
I think that's Yom Kippur.
Yeah.
We saw the movie on Channel 7, ABC 7.
Okay.
And whatever you were saying, that's in Quran.
Yeah.
It's the same thing in the movie.
They make movie. And you were seeing, yeah. They
show Harold and they show that how the Pharaoh was drowned.
Pharaoh was drowned. Yeah, they saw.
Allah Ta'ala saved Musa alayhi salam.
Yeah.
You know, when you see the movie, it makes more sense.
Yeah, it make more sense because you read in Quran and you saw that also, so it make more sense, mashallah. So, now, this is Ayah 57. And we shaded you with clouds and sent down to you manna and quails. So Allah sent the food for them. Now see, what is manna? Man, and it is called man and salwa, right? Mm-hmm. So man is, man or salwa. So, you know, man is, you know, man is kind of sweet gum. What is it? Man is kind of a sweet gum. And some scholars say it's a honeydew. You see the dew falling in the morning? Mm-hmm. Drop, drop, drop. It was a honeydew. And some say it was something, you know, drink, liquid, you know, drink, sweet drink. Okay, and a salwa. And salwa was a kind of bird that is quail. You see, quail is, you know, smaller than chicken. You eat chicken, right? Quail is, you know, just, you see the size of my hand, like this? It's just like this, you know. So Allah provided them sweet dish also and salty dish also. No.
Quail.
Quail is not quail. Bater. It is called bater. Small bater. So they were provided with these two things. Eat from the good thing. Yeah, so it is said that it was a sweet gum and a salwa, a kind of bird, that is quail. Narrated Sayyid bin Zaid, Allah's messenger said, the kumar truffle, that is a kind of edible fungus, is like the manna as it is obtained without any effort, and its water is a medicine cure for eye trouble. Now Sahabi says, Sayyid bin Zaid, that you know there's kuma, K-A-M-A, truffle, you know truffle? Truffle is kind of an edible fungus. Edible fungus, you know that? It's an edible fungus and it's just like manna. Just like manna, like a drop. And it is obtained very, without any effort, and its water is a medicine. Cure for our eye trouble. So we got the, cure we got the from Who is telling us? Said Ibn Zayd is telling us. Okay. So when we shaded you with clouds and sent on to you manna and quail, saying, eat from the good things which we have provided you, and they wronged us not, but they were only wronging themselves. Now what happened? That it is said that clouds were white in color. How were the clouds? White in color. And when they crossed the sea, they reached the desert of Sinai. Where they reached? Sinai. Sinai is a mount also. And here we have the hospital also, Mount Sinai. In Manhattan we have the hospital Mount Sinai. So they reached the desert of Sinai. They were in this desert for 40 years. How many years? 40 years. After 40 years, they entered Palestine. While they were in desert, no trees were there to shade. But in desert, you don't find any tree so that you can sit under the shade. Okay. In order to give them shade, Allah shaded them with clouds. See how merciful and how they were blessed. So Allah shaded them with the clouds. And it is said that those clouds were misty. How they were? The misty. You know, cool breeze, you know, because when the cloud is misty, you get cool breeze. So it saved them from the heat of the sun. You see, heat of the sun. So Allah was, you know, bestowed so many things and so merciful to them for them. And Allah sent down man and salwa, and they were enjoying this man and salwa. So they had the sweet dish also, and they had the salty dish also. Despite receiving all these blessings, they did not change. What they did? They did not change, and they were transgressing. They were not believing in Torah. Their life was not according to the Torah. Like we have got Quran. All the nations, all the messengers were given the book, or, you know, mm-hmm. or, you know, Sahife, or, yeah.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I only heard that
yeah.
only few people, the Jew people, only few, their mind did change.
Yeah, there will always be few people. Yeah, there were always few people. But, you know, Allah always talked generally, that what they did, you know, how they transgressed and everything. You know, in the last ayah, what we read, they demanded, they didn't wait it for this Torah also, the book also. They said to Musa alayhi salam, oh Musa, they saw in the way that some people were worshipping cow. And you know, these Pharaoh and his people, they used to worship cow also. And they were the slave. And they have seen people worshipping cow. So they, when Musa alayhi salam left, they started worshipping cow. You know that, you know? So they, you know, crossed the limit. So Allah says, they were zalimin, they were the wrongdoers. They wronged themselves, okay? Okay, now ayah 58. And remember when we said, enter the town, which town? Jerusalem. You know, they leave desert, which place they left? Egypt. They left Egypt and they came into the desert of Sinai. Where's the mount? Mount Sinai is there. And remember when we said, enter this town, where? Then when they entered Jerusalem, and eat bountifully therein with pleasure and delight, wherever you wish, and enter the gate in prostration for bowing with humility, and say, forgive us. Allah says, وَدْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا وَقُولُوا هِتَّةٌ. What do Allah told them to say? هِتَّةٌ نَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ خَتَيَاكُمْ وَسَنَزِيدُ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. You enter the gate in prostration or bowing with humility and say, forgive us, hittatun, forgive us, and we shall forgive you your sins and shall increase reward for the good doers. This is ayah 58. And recall when we said, enter the city, eat from it wherever you will with ease and in abundance. There was no restriction. Eat as much as you can, okay, in abundance. And enter the gate bowing humbly and say hittatun. Why bowing humbly? Bowing in gratitude, because Allah saved them from Pharaoh, you know. So, and you know, bestow them, you know, man and salwa, and you know, shaded with the clouds, Allah. So what they should have done? They should have been grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They should have been thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah said, you enter Jerusalem bowing, doing sajda, okay, in gratitude to Allah and in admission of sin. In admission, two things Allah said, in gratitude to Allah and also in admission of sin, that Ya Allah, we have done sin, so forgive us. What does hittatun means? Istaghfirullah. What does Ittatun mean? Istaghfirullah. Allah said you enter while prostrating, while bowing, and keep on saying Hittatun, Hittatun. Hittatun is an Hebrew word. It's not an Arabic. What is Hittatun? Ha-ta-ta. Ha-ta-ta. Hittatun is a Hebrew word. So it means, O Allah, forgive us. Relieve us of our burdens. Which burdens? The burdens of sins. Sins are the burdens, okay? They were told to say Hittatun. Why? To in admission of sin. We will then forgive your sins for you. If you say Hittatun, Istaghfirullah, Istaghfirullah, O Allah, forgive us, what we'll do? We'll forgive your sins. Allah always forgive our sins. When we say Istaghfirullah, when we do Tawbah, so the same thing Allah is saying, that we will then forgive your sins for you, and we will increase the doers of good in goodness and reward. Allah increase in goodness. When you say Istaghfirullah, when you do Tawbah, that Allah forgive me, and Allah gives the rewards. So, you understood what Hittatun is? What Hittatun means? Huh?
Is it all forgiveness?
Yeah, forgiveness. Istaghfirullah, Istaghfirullah, Istaghfirullah. Okay? Okay, now Ayah 59. But those who did wrong changed the word from that which had been told to them for another. So we sent upon the wrongdoers rich punishment. What is rich? فَبَدَّلَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا قَوْلًا غَيْرَ الَّذِي غَيْرَ الَّذِي they changed the word, okay? So what Allah did? فَانْزَلْنَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا رِزًا so we send upon wrongdoers rizq. Rizq is a punishment. What is rizq? Is a punishment from the heaven because of their rebelling against Allah's obedience. Okay? So Ayah 59, but they were told to say Hittatun, but they changed it to Hintatun. They added noon in it. Ha, ta, ta, they said Hittatun. Instead of Hittatun, they said Hintatun. Ha, noon, ta, ta. Tatwa, which means wheat. O Allah, give us wheat. O Allah, give us wheat. You understand? What is this? What is this showing? What is the attitude? Can anybody tell me? What you follow from? They were doing mockery. They take Allah's deen, you know, something, you know, very light. And they are mocking Allah. They are mocking Allah's blessings. They are mocking the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. They are mocking their messenger also. And this was their mockery, you know. And you know, it is said that instead of bowing and prostrating, Allah said bow. Entered Jerusalem while bowing. They entered sliding on their buttocks and saying, Hintatun, Hittatun, O Allah. Instead of saying, Istaghfirullah, 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 Hittatun, Hittatun. They said, Hintatun, Hintatun, O Allah, give us wheat, O Allah, give us wheat. They were mocking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we send down upon those who wrong a punishment from the sky because they were defiantly disobedient. And you see, here you find the word Rizam minas samai bima kanu yafsikun. We from the heaven, we sent upon the wrongdoers a punishment from the heaven because of their rebelling against Allah's obedience. And it is said that Riz is a punishment. It's a filthy punishment. It's a severe punishment. And you know, they were punished many times. They had a very filthy punishment, like, you know, bugs. Like, you know, grasshoppers, and all their water, you know, flooded with blood. Isn't it filthy? Everything, you know, and you know, lies were in their heads. Lies is so filthy. So, Rishun. Rishun means what type of punishment? Severe and filthy punishment. This is Ayah 59, okay? So, we send down upon those wronged one a punishment from the sky which was filthy, which was severe. Because they were defiantly disobedient. And it is said that Rizan is a plague. Plague is a disease. Does anybody know what is plague? Plague is caused by when the mouse bites somebody. Mouse bites somebody, okay? And in plague, you once get fever, one feels chill, vomiting, and, you know, skin irritation, headache. It's called plague. It is called, how it is caused? When the mouse, you know, bites somebody. So whenever you do, you know, I read somewhere that whenever you take tin foods, some, you know, there are many tin foods. So because in the storage, mouse are there in the storage where they keep these tin foods, you know. You know, you see in Food Plus and in your supermarkets from where they came. They come from the storage. They have a storage. So in the storage, there are mouse are there. And they urinate over the tins. So what always, whenever, you know, opening the tin, before opening the tin, always wash it with your, you know, washing liquid, you know, this your washing liquid from which you wash the utensils. So always wash the tin can, because that occurred anywhere, you know, I read. Sorry?
The soda cans.
The soda cans also. Yeah. Yeah, Uzma, sister Uzma is right. Never, you know, put your mouth on the cans, you know, the soda cans also. Always first wash it with some, you know, washing liquid, and then, you know, drink it. Because, you know, in the storage, you never know. It is a fact. There are, because many people died due to that, okay? So, this mouse is, the mice are very dangerous. Okay, so here it is. So by Quran, how many things you learn? See, you learn about what? Kuma, truffle, a fungus is good for the eyes, you know. The Sahabi is telling us, 1400 years before they use this, Kuma. Okay, so narrated Usama bin Zayd, Allah's messenger said, plague was a means of torture sent of group of Israelis or on some people before you. So if you hear, what is the reason, punishment? Plague was sent upon them. Okay, this punishment was plague. So if you hear of it, now listen what Allah says. If you hear of it spread in a land, don't approach it. If you're going to travel to some place, your tickets and your everything, your flight is ready. And you come to know from the news or by your people are saying, oh, here there is a plague. So when you hear that the plague has spread in the land, don't approach it. Cancel your flight, your tickets, everything. Who says? Prophet says. What you do? When you hear that in some land there is a plague, so you shouldn't go there. Okay? And if plague should appear in a land where you are present, then what you will do? Come on, tell me. No. Then don't leave this land in order to run away from it. That is plague. Don't leave your land. If it is in your land, don't leave your land. And if in some other city, somebody other's land, and you come to know and you have tickets and everything is ready, though your suitcase is packed, everything is there, you don't go there. Because what happened? If you go, yeah, my spread. Okay? And don't go there. And if it is in your land, then don't leave your land. Why? Yeah. It was also, you know, but then, you know, if there is any disease, any epidemics over there in your place where you are, don't leave that place. Have trust on Allah. You know, you may not be afflicted. It's Allah's will. If Allah wishes, you will, you know, catch that disease. If Allah doesn't wish, you won't catch. Everything comes by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, your tawakkal, your iman, your faith, your trust should be in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't be, you know, scary, be afraid, be frightened. Why? Why not to be frightened, scary and scared? Trust in Allah. Because what is, you know, written in your destiny is going to happen. So why, you know, you should be scary and, you know, leave the prayers and always, you know, not, you know, in peace. Stay in peace. Live in peace, you know. Don't be, you know, scary or something, okay? Leave, because if you have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you won't be scared. There will be no worries, you know. You won't be scary or frightened of anything. Okay, now we finish this 57. Okay. Despite receiving all these blessings, they did not change. This was 57, then 58. No, we did 60. We did 60. Okay. And recall when Musa prayed. Now there is another blessing. See. 60. And remember, see, first what we read, first of all, Pharaoh was drowned. You know, they were saved from the, aggression of the Pharaoh, because Pharaoh used to kill their boys and let live their daughters. Okay.
Feared because there's going to be
the king. He has a dream that somebody from Bani Israelis would be the king of the land. So he used to kill. So they were saved from the aggression of the Pharaohs. Then Allah shaded them with the clouds. Then, you know, Allah sent to them man and salwa, the sweet dish, the salty dish. And if man and salwa, if something is sent to you, and if you don't have to cook, you don't have to go for grocery, you don't have to earn money, then the whole day you are free. Nothing to do, only to fill the tummy. Only to fill the tummy, you find jobs. You don't get jobs. Sometimes per hour, $12, $13, $15, you know. And you know, you have to go for interviews. Then, you know, 2 hours wasted in your train or subway or by car, or you know, time is wasted. Then you get the job, then always you are scared. Oh, if I, my work is not up to the standard, you know, job, boss will kick me. From where I will eat, okay? From morning to evening, you go, you earn, you bring the money. Then you shop around, you do the grocery for your food, grains and rice and oil and, you know, everything. Then you come home, put them in your cabinets, then you cook. You know, the whole day where it goes, just to fill the stomach. All these, you know, hurdles, all these efforts. But if somebody get the food, and that is also from the heaven, man and salva, more tastier than our food. So they should have been thankful to Allah. And the time was being saved. And why? Because they were the chosen one at that time. You know, that nation was the chosen one. So they had the time to spread Islam, Allah's word, do, you know, good worship, become closer to Allah, you know. Instead of doing all these things, they, you know, they were the, you know, very demanding people, you know, they crossed the limits, they transgressed. And then Mano Salwa, see, then now Allah is, you know, describing another blessing on them. Ayah number 60. And remember when Musa asked for water for his people, now in the desert, they will need water also because it was a desert. In desert, there was no ocean, no sea, no stream, no pond, nothing. So when Musa asked for water for his people, we said, strike the stone with your stick. Musa alayhi salam was blessed with a stick. That was a miracle. Okay. That was a miracle. He had a stick. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that, O Musa, just strike the stone. Just strike the stone with your stick. Then gush forth therefrom 12 springs. Then what happened? When Musa alayhi salam stroked the stone with the stick, then gush forth therefrom 12 springs. How many springs? Not one. 12 springs. Okay. Each group of people knew its own place for water. Why 12 springs? Because Musa, they had 12 tribes. To save them from fighting and, you know, beating and killing and, you know, quarreling each other. You know, so much peace. So much peace.
I'm kind of confused. Why was it throwing? What was it throwing?
Sorry?
What was it? I'm really confused.
It sticked you.
Musa alayhi salam has some miracles.
Okay.
Allah gave them a stick.
The serpent.
Skin. And that stick, you know, turned the when Allah, when he used to, you know, drop the stick, it is used to change it into a snake.
Yeah,
snake, yeah. You learn. I'm not, you know.
Story.
I'm not telling. We'll learn through ayahs. Everything is going to come about the snakes also, and you know. So we'll through ayahs, it will come in your lesson.
Right.
So we'll do because here we'll be taking more time then. By the ayahs, we learn everything. The whole story is there. Yeah, okay. What happened? They were in the desert. Okay. Allah blessed Musa alayhi salam and its people.
Okay.
When, you know, they left Egypt, you know, Musa alayhi salam found a river in front of him. Okay. Allah said, don't get scared. Oh, Musa, don't get scared. Just
a river.
Because they were, Allah told them to leave Pharaoh's country,
okay.
Egypt, because he was, you know, an aggressor king on them. You know, they used to kill their boys and, you know, many things they used to do on them. So finally Allah said, you leave Egypt. And when they left Egypt at night, Allah told them to leave at night. So the Pharaoh and his people may not come to know that you are leaving. They were, while they were sleeping.
Okay.
At night everybody sleep.
Yeah.
You were not there in this. Oh yeah, she wasn't there. So it's a revision also, right? Everybody following? So you have forgotten also. So they left Egypt.
Okay.
They were in Egypt, Misr. So they left Egypt. And when they left Egypt, they came, Musa alayhi salam saw water, a river, you know. And then Allah said that, oh Musa, don't be scared. What you do? You just strike your stick. That stick is a miracle. So when he stroked the stick, that water, you know, parted. Parted. The water parted and it was a land. So Musa alayhi salam and his nation, Bani Israelis, they crossed the water because it was a land. Yeah, he was wrong. Then when Pharaoh came to know, he became angry. He said they have left. So they all followed Pharaoh and his people. All Bani Israel, all the Egypt people, they followed Musa alayhi salam. As soon as they reached the same place, you know, it again changed into river. And Musa alayhi salam and Bani Israelis, all these nations crossed. And Pharaoh was drowned. And now they left the place, they reached to a desert. Desert of Sinai, where there's a Mount Sinai. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayah, from ayah 55, yeah? We started from ayah 55, that when they were in the desert, while they were in the desert, we shaded them with a cloud. And it is said it was a white cloud and misty cloud. And when there's mist, you know, you get chill air. Cool air. Not so cool that you're feeling, you know, it's a winter, I need a cardigan, you know, not like that. You know, so to save them from what? From sun. When it is, whenever you see it's about to rain, now you see sun over there, bright sun. See the from the window. And if it is cloudy and it's about to rain, then there's no sun, you know. It looks so nice, okay. You know, it's a shaded. So Allah shaded them. And then Allah, it was a desert. No cultivation, no, you know, agriculture, nothing. So in desert, you can't do. Desert land, the deserted land is barren. It's not fertile. Is that land fertile? The fertile lands only can give, you know, you can bore the seeds and the trees come out and the grains come out. Fertile lands give you. So what Allah did? Allah, from heavens, Allah sent them, what? Man and salwa. Salwa was a quail, a bird, like we eat chicken. We like flesh. You know, human being like flesh of chicken or the goat or sheep or, you know, camel. So they were bestowed quail like some, you know, salwa. Salwa was, yeah, in the desert. Yeah, they didn't appreciate it. They didn't like it. And we have the, you know, always craving for some sweet also. And what the kids do? They'll go to the fridge and take all the chocolates and things and spoil their teeth. We have the craving, you know. It is our nature. So Allah fulfill all their craving, all their things. The quail was, you know, and it is said it was cooked. They didn't, you know, wanted to, they didn't have to cook also. It was cooked, you know, some salty like dish thing, like a quail, a bird type of, okay. And then there was no water. Of course, in the desert, there was no water. So in ayah 60, in ayah number 60, Allah says, And remember, wise, remember. Allah is telling them, you know, see what I did with you. Just remember, just see. Yeah.
When you said that there was a river that they had to cross in the desert. So, but you also said that the desert doesn't have any water.
No, they crossed Egypt. They crossed Egypt. Allah said you leave Egypt. You leave Egypt, you know. When Musa alayhi salam left Egypt and he came to a place, it was a river. He saw that river is in my front and at the back, Pharaoh would be there. You know, emergency in front also and at the back also. Now what should I do? Allah said, just, you know, strike your stick into the water and why? Because it was a miracle from Allah's one. And the stick was also a miracle. When he struck the stick, that water aparted, you know. Parted two sides, left and right, and in the middle was a plain, you know, a desert, a land. So he crossed. And when Pharaoh came to know, he followed with the people. And when Pharaoh reached at that point where there was river, because when Musa alayhi salam was parted, again it was a river. Because it was a river. And it became plain for whom? For Musa alayhi salam. It was a miracle. Okay? Understand? Okay. You got the point? Okay. You know, Allah can do anything. He say kun and fayakun. He say kun be, fayakun and it be. What does kun mean? Be and fayakun, it be. What Allah wish, what Allah wills, it happens and Allah does. Okay? So what happened? And remember when Musa asked for what Allah is addressing Bani Israelis. Okay? And remember when Musa asked for water for his people. Because when they crossed the Egypt, you know, they reached to a desert. Mount Sinai Desert. Where they reach? Sinai Desert. So Allah, there was no water. So we said, strike the stone with your stick, then gush forth therefrom 12 springs. Why 12 springs? Because there were 12 tribes of Bani Israel. Okay? There were 12 tribes. So if there was one spring, what would happen? there would have been queue, you know, and you know, they would have been fighting, they would have been quarreling. I will fill the water first, I'll drink the water first. So what Allah did? Gave them peace. Allah, how many springs gushed forth? 12. How they gushed forth? By the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Musa alayhi salam had a miraculous stick. That staff was miraculous. It is called STAFF also. You know that? What is STAFF? Staff. It is called staff also, and it is called stick also. Okay? So don't get confused. In some translation, you will find STAFF, staff. Okay? Stick and staff is the same thing. Okay? So when Musa alayhi salam stroked the stick on the miraculous stick on the stone, there gushed forth 12 spring. Eat and drink of that which Allah has provided and do not act corruptly, making mischief on the earth. Now be at peace. Eat and drink manna and salwa. And you have the water also. So what to do? What Allah said? Eat and drink what we have provided you and be at peace. Don't corrupt. Don't do fasad. Don't do corruption on the earth. Don't transgress. You know, whatever is ordained in Torah, you know, your life should be according to the Torah. So don't corrupt in the land. Okay, this was ayah 6.
When you say 12 springs, you mean 12 ponds?
12?
Ponds or wells?
Streams.
Streams, okay.
Yeah, 12 streams.
Water.
Because Quran has, the Quran says these were the springs. Water springs.
They were divided into 12 tribes.
12. They were 12. 12 springs.
12 springs were divided into 12 tribes.
12 tribes, yeah. 12 springs, yeah, she's correct. 12 springs were divided into 12 create. And further see, very nice ayah. Each group of people knew its own place for water.
Yeah.
And 12 of them know which one is for me, which one is for which tribe, which one is for which tribe. See. See the explanation, Quran. Okay. Now ayah 61. In 5 minutes we'll conclude. And recall when you said, "Oh Musa, we can never endure one kind of food." It's very interesting, and you know, this is their transgression, this is their, you know, ungratefulness. Try to listen carefully this ayah and the explanation. And remember when you said, Allah is addressing whom? Bani Israel. That you remember when you said so, when you did so. "Oh Musa, Moses, we cannot endure one kind of food, so invoke your Lord for us to bring forth for us of what the earth grows. The herbs, the cucumbers, the farm, what is farm? Wheat or garlic, its lentils and its onions." They were not satisfied with the heavenly food. They wanted what the earth grow. What the earth grow? What? Herbs, cucumbers, wheat, garlic. Your mom also put, you know, garlic to make your curry tasty, you know. And lentils. Sometimes you see the lentils red, you know, yellowish,
green,
you know. So we want all these things. And the onions, while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in the hadith that, you know, these onions and garlic is smelly. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, when you go to the mosque for the Jummah prayers or any prayers, never eat, before going to mosque, don't eat garlic or onions. So that you don't disturb your, you know, fellow beings who are praying with you with the smell, with the bad smell. So, and you see, there was no smell in man and salwa, in the quail and in the gum, the dew drops, the honey drops.
Yeah.
Some people say honey drops, dew drops, you know, or the liquid. So they were so ungrateful people. See, for this, all these things, cucumber and onions and garlic, we have to earn, we have to grocery shop and all. So, you know, what type of people they were, ungrateful. And, you know, see, here Allah says, وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَىٰ لَن نَصْبِرَ عَلَىٰ طَعَامٍ وَاحِدٍ فَادْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ فَادْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ call your Rabb. They were such arrogant people that they didn't call their Rabb, "Oh Allah, oh our Lord." فَادْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ, "Oh Musa, you call your Rabb." Oh Musa, you kafad ulana rabbaka. Whenever they wanted something, they were in difficulty, they used to say, "Musa, call your Rabb."
And they knew that Allah was there.
Allah was there.
They just say it from their mouth.
Yeah, you are correct. She says, they knew Allah is there, but they themselves, they didn't, you know, say astaghfirullah, no forgiveness, not calling Allah directly. Indirect, their behavior was indirect. They were so arrogant, you know. So, "Oh Musa, call your Rabb." Okay. Okay, then what happened? He said, "Would you exchange that which is better for that which is lower?" See, Musa alayhi salam, what is he telling? When they said, oh Musa, call your Rabban, we want onions and, you know, cucumbers and lentils and all these things and garlic and whatnot. So Musa alayhi salam, would you exchange that which is better for that which is lower? Worldly things are lower than, you know, humanly things. Human food is higher, something, you know. So you, it's better. Oh, go you down to any town and you shall find you want. So Musa alayhi salam said, go, leave this place. Go to some town, leave the desert and go to some town. And in the town, in the Misr, Misr is called town. And Misr is the name of the country also, which they leave and they came here to the desert of Sinai. So Musa alayhi salam telling them, you are living the better thing and you are exchanging with the lower thing. So leave this desert and go to some town. Yeah, go to some town, you'll find all these things in the town. The grocery shops and, you know, the agricultural land, and there you'll find that. Okay. And they were covered with humiliation and misery, and they drew on themselves the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When every time Allah is blessing you, you know, with the clouds, with manu salwa, with water, with everything, and when they were ungrateful, what will happen? Allah's wrath will fall. Allah will be angry, you know, and you will be humiliated, you know. Allah was giving them higher rank, you know. Allah chose them, you know. And what, see their attitude. That was because they used to disbelieve the ayah. What was the ayahs? Proofs, evidences, verses. The miracle of the stick was the greatest evidence. They saw with their own eyes that when Musa al-Islam stroked the stick on the water aparted. Water was part apart and it became the plain lane, plain, you know, earth, and they crossed there. And then again, for the water, what Musa did? Allah said, you strike your stick and, you know, gush forth how many springs? 12. The evidences were there. The proofs were there. The Torah was there. The verses were there. The lessons were there. The signs were there. The revelation in the shape of Torah was there. Okay? Torah was the revelation. When they didn't believe, they transgressed. They were the wrongdoers. So, they used to disbelieve the ayah, proofs, evidences, verses, lessons, signs, revelations, etc. of Allah, and kill the prophets wrongly. They used to kill the prophets also. They used to kill the prophets also. Instead of, you know, obeying the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the scriptures which were sent to the prophets, they used to say, come on, you know, straight away they used to kill. There would be no one to tell us. We don't have to come out from our comfort zones. And we don't have to listen. And we don't have to change ourselves, what we are doing. We are okay with what we are doing, all wrong things, all corruptions, you know, all aggressions, all arrogance, everything, you know. So, that was because they disobeyed and used to transgress the bounds in their disobedience to Allah, that is, commit crimes and sins. Understand? They used to commit all the crimes and sins. Okay. Now we did number 61. And recall when you said, O Musa, we can never endure one kind of food. We cannot eat the same food every day. What was the demand? Oh, what is this? Every day we are going to eat what? What they used to eat every day? Man and salwa. So we are not going to eat every day man and salwa. And they said, we need a change in the menu. They want to change the menu. the menu should be changed. Oh, what we? It's a boredom. It's a boredom eating, you know, one thing. So call upon your Lord, Sifat Qalud Ulana Rabbaka, call upon your Lord to bring forth for us from the earth the green herbs and its cucumbers and its garlic and its lentils and its onions. So what should be the what should be our aim? Listen carefully. We should be purposeful people. What should we be? Purposeful people. They were not purposeful people. They were not contented on man and salwa, the heavenly diet. People who have a purpose in their lives, they simply their lives by bringing simplicity in their food. Those who have got purpose, what they do? They bring simplicity in their lives. In the morning, they don't demand parathas and, you know, omelette, and because they know it's 1 hour to reach the college. If won't get up early, and if my mouth is smelly, and if I'm not taking shower, if my college school starting at 8 o'clock, I have to get up 2 hours before, 1 hour for the, you know, transport, and 1 hour, you know, my cleanliness and everything. And if I eat parathas and everything, and I will be more sleepy. This, you know, ghee and this greasy thing, where will end up? you fill your stomach, whole stomach, you will be sleepy. So what they do? Because you have the purpose in life. So you will just eat, you know, cereals or, you know, yeah, or boiled egg, oatmeal, something which is nutritive, nutritive, which give you, you know, energy and which is not a junk food. And not the, you know, heavy food, which the parathas and everything which make you sleepy, that you are unable to do anything. Because you have got purpose of life. What lesson you are getting today? Is it good lesson or not? By Quran. So you will come every Sunday? Come? Okay. So your life shouldn't go astray. You should have a aim. High ambitious. A purpose. Okay? Okay. They do not live to eat. What they do? Those who are purposeful, they do not live to eat. Eating, eating, eating. I am living because I want to eat everything. My life is for eating. They live to eat. You got the difference? They do not live to eat. They eat to live. Little, energetic, not junk. You know, the food that don't draw you sleepy. Got the point? Okay. And your teacher is asking you some question. You gone. Because the greasy food, the paratha and the junk is in your stomach. Though it is nutritive. But eat paratha also, you know, 1/4 or half. If you fill 2 and 1 full, then what will happen, you know? That doesn't mean you shouldn't eat paratha. It's also nutritive. But not much ghee and all that. You are getting fatter and fatter and fatter. You eat paratha. But, you know, Prophet, there's a hadith that you should live. You should, you know, if you have the appetite for one bread, one slice, one roti, you eat 3/4. How much will you eat? 3/4. Leave one part for air, one part for the food to get digestive, okay? You know what you do? One part for air, one part, because your machine, your abdomen, your, you know, arteries, they, you know, they digest food also. So we don't leave space. One part for water, one part for your food, and one part, leave the space in your tummy to so that all your abdomen is able to digest it. It's a machinery, it moves, okay? Okay. So, their goal is not to savor the world, but to save the world. And in order to save the world, sometimes they have to give up on their taste also. You have to give up your taste also, okay? On what they eat also. So they eat what is sufficient to bring them strength. What they eat, which is sufficient to bring them strength. What is sufficient to improve their ibadah and to lead productive lives. Understand? Come on, tell me. What type of food you will eat?
Nutritious.
Nutritious, which give you strength, which is sufficient to improve your ibadah. You have eaten such a lot, you know, you have eaten over than your appetite. Then you feel sleepy. Then you are praying also, you think, oh! You know, your prayers are also not good. You don't understand what you are saying. What surah, what is the meaning of Suratul Fatiha? Subhanar al-Azim, Subhanar al-Azim, Subhanar al-Ala, you don't know. You are so sleepy. So your ibadah is also not good. So the food should be sufficient for your ibadah, for your prayers. And your life should be productive or unproductive?
Productive.
But when people lack purpose in life, when you lack purpose, there is no purpose in your life, then they begin to desire on the delicacy after another. Then you are desirous, you know. Your desires are more. You got this thing, now I want this thing, now I want that thing. Hundreds and thousands of lists you will have. Because you purposeless life. No school, no college. If you are going to school, you are going just for going. You know, because everybody is going. I am going to school. There is no purpose that I want to be a doctor or an engineer. I have to serve my family. I have to serve the country. I have to serve the people, you know. So there should be a purpose in life. So from today, what you will do? Purposeful life, productive life, okay? Okay? Not the desires, one after the other, okay? And who could be more useless than the one who is described over here? They were useless people. Who are described over here? Bani Israel. And they were useless people because there's no purpose in life. You know, they wanted all type of food. That doesn't mean that you stop eating lentils and everything. Eat everything, enjoy the food. What Allah says in this ayah? That enjoy. Enjoy the food. Okay? And the one who does not make, may even make dua himself, you have to make dua. Where then you will get your aim and ambitious. They had no purpose in life. So they used to say, "Oh Musa, qalu dulana rabbaka. Oh Musa, call your Rabb, call your Rabb." You don't say your teacher or your mother pray for me. You will sell. You know, mother's prayers also accepted when you have an exam or a test or an assignment or some difficult task. You should ask your mom, but you yourself also going to do dua. Our behavior shouldn't be like Bani Israelis. Got the point? Okay. He says you make dua, you ask Allah to give us and this. Allah says you make dua and ask Allah to give us this and this food and all the things. Don't say, like, you know, we shouldn't be like Bani Israelis. Qalu dulana rabbaka. Oh, Musa, call your Rabb. Okay? Okay. Musa alayhi salam said, would you exchange what is better for what is less? Go into any settlement and indeed you will have what you have asked. You go. You leave this place. You go to some, you know, town and country and you'll get. You will find these foods in grocery stores. Go chase the world if that is what is your desire. Chase the world. Go the whole day. Worry and do efforts. Okay? They were getting without any efforts, you know. And they were covered with humiliation and poverty and returned with anger from Allah upon them. And this was because they repeatedly disbelieved in the signs of Allah and killed the prophets without light. Repeatedly they were disbelieving. They were not happy with Manu Salwa. They were not happy with the clouds. They were not happy with the water. They never realized the blessings which were bestowed on them by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were always ungrateful. That was because they disobeyed and were habitually transgressing. Allah's anger, Allah's punishment, Allah's curse befall these people. What happens? Allah's anger, Allah's punishment, Allah's curse befell these people. Why? Yeah, they were ungrateful because they did not accept Allah's orders. They did not accept and rejected His blessings. And they did not value Allah's gift. What they did? Not accept Allah's orders. Rejected His blessings. MashaAllah, you are writing. And they did not value Allah's gifts. So today you value Allah's gifts. Your mother, your father, your parents are the gifts. Your brothers, sisters are the gifts. Don't fight with your younger brother. Love your younger brother and sister. Okay? You know, help him with the classwork, schoolwork. Your mother work a lot. She need your help. Everybody listening to me? It's not only for Fatima. It's for everybody, for me also. My mother is sick on the bed. I should go to Pakistan and I should help my sister. Okay? So, and value, these are Allah's gifts. Your parents, your brother, sister, the food your father brings. He, your mother and father, your parents work whole day for you. Mom in the kitchen, in the house is clean, food is ready, and don't just come and, you know, bang your bag. Oh, I'm tired, I'm not going to do. Just, you know, keep your bag at the proper place, your shoes at the proper place, you know. You're learning for yourself or not for your mother. You know, this education, this school your mom is sending, that is also a gift, Allah's gift. So you have to value. From today you will value. Come on, tell me and we'll conclude. What you will value, how you will value. The gifts of Allah. Everybody, yes?
By helping your parents.
Helping your parents. Thanking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Grateful to Allah and to the parents also. Mm-hmm. And
pray five times.
Yeah, and help your mom. And, you know, helping your younger brothers and sisters also. Not always be demanding. I didn't mean that you stop all these lanterns and all things. That doesn't mean. Mm-hmm. You know, they are all energetic food. Okay, lanterns, cucumber. Allah doesn't say that stop all this. This is said because they were getting heavenly, they were getting the food from where? From heavens. There was a heavenly food. And they wanted the food which was, we were talking about Bani Israel. Okay, you eat all the food, the lentils, the cucumber, the onions, the garlic. Because nowadays we are not getting any, you know, miraculous food or the heaven, you know, heavenly food. So this is the food for us. This is the gift. These food are also gift nowadays, you know. This is the time, at the time of Musa alayhi salam. So eat all the food, okay? Understand? Okay. But healthy food. Got the point? Okay. Everything is clear, so we'll conclude. Just listen to the recitation. Open your Quran, Ayah 55. We'll start from 55, 56, 57 and absorb in your heart that what you learn. What you learn from this ayah. I'm also opening the ayah. Okay. Fatma, you better to bring your Quran next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Say Darush Sharif, everybody.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallayta ala وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد.
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.